Hey, welcome back to Cannabis TV.
You bet, we're here on the air.
Yeah.
What's up?
Eugene, Oregon.
Eugene, Oregon, yep. Well, here's something just in today's topics. This is a lawsuit challenging financial aid ban for student drug offenders. Washington, D.C., the American Civil Liberties Union Drug Law Reform Project, along with Students for Sensible Drug Policy, have filed a federal case action suit against the U.S. Department of Education challenging the constitutionality of the constitutional ban on financial aid for students convicted of a minor drug crime while attending college. The lawsuit contends that the federal ban is unconstitutional because it amounts to double jeopardy, further penalizing students who have already been criminally sanctioned by the courts. The suit also argues that the law violates students' right to due process and disproportionately impacts minorities, which is very true. Yeah.
This is real important for U of O students, Lane community students. Listen up, because this is pertaining to you.
You bet, because this law seeks to ensure that no student will ever again have to worry about losing their financial aid, and with it, their access to higher education because of a minor drug conviction. So it is a very important issue.
Yeah,
and
there's
for people going to U of O.
Representative on campus at the University of Oregon with that group, too.
Oh,
so
excellent.
If you're out there, get a hold of us and we can get you in contact, because that's important work that's going on there.
Oh, you bet. You bet. And you've got something for us also, Dan.
Yeah, this one I got a kick out of. This is, I don't know what state this is, it says a Horry County grand jury indicted a former officer from J. Reuben Long Detention Center on charge that he furnished marijuana to inmates at the jail. Well, that was nice of him. I don't know, two indictments charge Albert Bellamy, who had worked at J. Reuben about 6 years, with misconduct in office and distribution of marijuana. These indictments were among 342 returned by the grand jury last week. Boy, a bunch of busy little people, aren't they? 342. Bellamy was charged in January. The documents say he helped distribute marijuana at the jail around January 8th. He was fired from his job soon after he was charged. J. Reuben Long officials received information that contraband was being brought into the facility and provided to inmates by a detention officer. Bellamy had a container of food that held 4 cigarettes and 3 ounces of green leafy substance thought to be marijuana, according to the members of the Horry County Sheriff's Office and the Horry County Police Department, who conducted a joint investigation.
A joint investigation.
Yeah. You know, they're funny. Somebody on the staff has got a sense of humor there on that story.
Oh, yeah. Well, it's too bad that he wasn't giving some medicine to Susan Lambert Smith. This is a story about a woman that got incarcerated. Actually, it's a pretty sad story. She was actually living with another guy. She found a place to stay because she was on disability and all that kind of stuff. And she found a place to stay. Well, she had to cook and clean and tend this guy's marijuana plants. Well, the guy that she was living with got busted, and so she even turned herself in. She was even away from the farm because she was afraid of the guy that was growing the marijuana. Turned herself in. They put her in jail. She died of congestive heart failure on March 2nd, shortly after being assigned to a minimum security camp for women. It's too bad he wasn't giving a little bit of marijuana to her.
Yeah.
So. This is a medicine.
Yeah, it
and
sure
it's
is.
It's an ancient medicine.
That's right.
That the government is pulling the hemp over our eyes and lying to us.
That's right.
And to our forefathers as well.
You bet.
PK is showing his Oregon Medical Marijuana Program cards. And that's the real deal. It's interesting thing is that it doesn't say marijuana anywhere on the card.
No, it doesn't. Does it?
Which strikes me as kind of funny. But anyway, so it's legal to use. And speaking of that, I had a story here, and of course, I probably didn't bring it out with me. But Rhode Island is now.
I got it.
Oh, you got the Rhode Island.
Rhode Island just decided to basically make medical marijuana legal. If you have a debilitating medical condition, meaning cancer, glaucoma, positive status for human immune deficiency virus, hepatitis C, all kinds of different ones. The application fee is $75 unless you are on SSI or Medicaid, and then it will be reduced to $10. And a multiple sclerosis patient who hopes to use marijuana to ease pain symptoms of her disease, became the first person to apply for state permission to legally use the drug under the new Rhode Island law Wednesday. So,
hallelujah.
Yeah, she says, I'm just so thankful that our legislatures have been compassionate enough to care about the disabled. So that's pretty good news there.
Yeah.
That she'll be able to use her medicine along with a lot of other people in Rhode Island.
Yep.
So that
yep.
makes 12. We're making a little headway anyway.
Yeah, yeah.
So.
This is interesting. This is a, you know, when you find something that's been written, it's always helpful to know who's written it and
sure.
see where they're coming from. And mm-hmm. This is out of Georgia, and this is written by Michael C. Barnes. And here it says, Michael C. Barnes is a Washington lawyer who formerly served as counsel in the Office of National Drug Policy. National Drug Control Policy. So now listen to this. It says, kudos to Georgia state senators who voted in favor of a bill to prevent the sale of marijuana-flavored candy.
Oh.
Members of the Agriculture and Consumer Affairs Committee realized that the availability of hemp candy on store shelves is harmful to our children and undermines Georgia's anti-drug laws. Thank heaven the people in Georgia can be safe because they don't have any marijuana-tasting candy. Bill 511, which did not win final legislative approval this year, only scratched the surface. Next session's bill must be more protective. Hemp is a low-potency cannabis, i.e. marijuana. That's
and that's kind of a yeah, wrong statement, isn't
yeah,
it?
Yeah, that's interesting. Read that again. Now listen to this. Hemp is a low-potency cannabis, i.e. marijuana. That's
yeah, it's great. A no-potency.
Yeah. Hemp products are being freely sold to anyone who walks into certain specialty food stores.
Mm.
These stores carry items such as cereals, salad dressings, protein powders, and dietary supplements that contain small amounts of THC, a hallucinogenic substance.
Hallucinogenic?
I never.
Say that three times.
You know, that's one of the things they say the side effects of marijuana is hallucinogenic, you know, is yeah. Hallucinations. Really?
I've never had a hallucination.
I must not get me in a good pot because I have never had a hallucination.
No, neither have I.
Another thing, too, I want to mention this. This is interesting. I saw a trade magazine one time as a trucking magazine, and they were talking about drugs and talked about. You know, cocaine and crack and all this stuff and all mm-hmm. the symptoms, what to look for and all this. But there was one common side effect with every drug that they had listed, paranoia.
Mm.
Which struck me as funny because, well, yeah, the drug's illegal, so you're going to be paranoid.
You're
going to
be paranoid whatever
you know?
You're using that's illegal, yeah.
Yes, that cracks me up. Anyway, this clown here, anyway, he goes, yeah, the whole point is it's telling, you know, can't have marijuana candy, which is because it's a danger to our kids.
And it's
know.
Not even real marijuana in the
clown.
Candy, is it?
No,
it's just flavored,
no.
right?
Exactly, yeah.
Just the flavor.
Exactly.
Oh my goodness, if they
know,
got the flavor
like,
in their mouth, they want, right. might want it forever, right?
That's right. It's just like your Happy Leaflay that you're wearing.
Oh yeah.
I've worn that and had people ask me if it's legal to have that.
To wear a plastic
to have a to have a facsimile of a pot plant. Is that legal? That's scary when somebody asks
that. That is scary. It makes you wonder if you really live in a free country,
oh,
I'll tell you.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, and this guy, by elected candidate convicted on drug charge, a marijuana advocate who is running in Thursday's Nepal Carleton by election, was convicted Wednesday on a drug possession charge. John Trammell was arrested 3 years ago when he took 3 grams of marijuana to Parliament Hill. Trammell was whose advocates for loosening restrictions on use of drugs also smoked marijuana during his one-man protest and offered to share it with the politicians. That's what the politicians need, don't
yeah,
they?
Yeah, this is out of Canada now.
Yeah. Trammell was sentenced to 3 months probation, fined $1,000, and ordered to perform 100 hours of community service. He argued that people are being wrongly prosecuted for drug possession and said he plans to appeal the decision. So the politician candidate is running as an independent by election to replace former Tory MPP John Baird. So, yeah.
Yeah, again, speaking of Canada.
Oh, yes.
Canada's parliament was in session today for the first time after the election. The first time on the agenda, more power to prohibition and cops.
Mm.
A very ominous sign for the Canadian cannabis culture. The former government, Liberal government, was introduced a law to legalize cannabis. But now that the Conservatives are back in power, they're saying, "No, we're not doing that." So,
Oh, yeah.
We're doing another 180 here.
It's so sad. And this is a great article off the computer, Should Marijuana Be Legal? Well, I'll just read you a little bit. As America's government continues to wage a costly war on drugs, it's necessary to objectively acknowledge that legalization of marijuana is an idea that should receive serious consideration without succumbing to the subjectivity of propaganda. And it's not our first battle over legalization. For another comparison that's closer to home, we look at our own history when attempts were made to obliterate the use of alcohol during the Prohibition era of the 1920s. Although consumption of alcohol fell at the beginning, it just went underground and you had more and more, and you know, the government kept increasing more and more money, spending it on that, and you know, it was just a waste of time. Mm-hmm. You know, and I love this. At a time of serious security concerns and government deficits, a hard look needs to be given to ensure that public funds are spent effectively. The government must also learn from its past and meet its people's demands, or else time eventually will. Although the demand for alcohol is now satisfied, as the demand for cigarettes, marijuana is still lagging behind in its own prohibition era. No one can deny that alcohol and cigarettes lack any significant benefit to our society, but these commodities have been made illegal. We live in a country where freedom of choice takes priority and ultimately cannot be denied. Consider the words of the former President Woodrow Wilson, a New Jersey native. Liberty has never come from the government. Liberty always comes from its subjects. And the history of liberty is the history of resistance. So obviously, you know, just like our forefathers before, mm-hmm. you know, we must resist. We must stand up for our rights or we lose them.
Yeah, you know? I know it. So I always say your rights is like a muscle. You don't use it, you're going to lose it.
Yeah, that's so true.
Yeah, definitely. And by the way, excuse me, I want to make a note to myself, but I want to mention this. Our Emerald Empire Hemp Fest telephone is working again.
Oh.
It was down and we didn't even know it. Mm-hmm. So it was down for quite some time. So if you've been trying to call and couldn't get through, try again and you will get through.
All
so
right.
You'll see the number come up on the screen. And also donations. I wanted to thank, we have another donor, same guy that donated some money to us last year to get up to Seattle Hemp Fest.
Mm-hmm.
He stepped forward again and helped us again by making another donation, which will give us our money for our nonprofit for the Emerald Empire Hemp Fest, as well as the new normal chapter we're starting.
Oh, awesome.
So this is great, but we need more people to stand up and step forward and you know, things like that.
You bet.
And also Dank Bagman is going to the normal conference if you'd like to help. It's a $150 fee for the conference, so I could sure use some help with that. So if anybody donate, the information's on the screen. Get a hold of us and make sure you use some help.
Oh, you bet. Well, I think we're going to be going to a break and watching a clip.
Oh, good. I need to relax.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, so anyway, I think we're going to be watching the marijuana monologue.
Yeah.
I smoke two joints at night. I smoke two joints in the afternoon. It makes me feel alright. I smoke two joints in time of peace and two in time of war. I smoke two joints before I smoke two joints.
Marijuana.
Marijuana.
Marijuana. There, we said it.
Marijuana. Said it again.
We say it because we want to feel comfortable saying it, not ashamed and guilty. We worry about marijuana. We worry about what people think about marijuana users. We worry about getting caught with marijuana. But mostly, we worry about getting more marijuana.
You've got to know a guy to get marijuana. We worry that something could happen to the marijuana guy. We worry that we'll have to get a new marijuana guy. What if he doesn't answer our page when we need him? What if his mother doesn't know where he is? We found out what other marijuana smokers had to say about marijuana. We talked to old marijuana smokers. We talked to young, black, Jewish, handicapped marijuana smokers. We talked to rich, homeless, gay, and even Chinese marijuana smokers. And it took a long, long time, because once you get a marijuana smoker talking, they never shut up. Marijuana is a mistress who goes by many names. She's also known as pot, weed, El Diablo de Verde, wiggity, jazz plants, Lando Calrissian, Kermit the Hogleg, Dr. Fill My Pipe Up, Mr. THC, Your Highness, Harry Potter, my only real friend, Wacky Tobacky, Sticky Icky Icky, Jean-Claude Van Amsterdam, Henry VIII, Bill Marijuana. Mother Nature's way of saying hi. Marijuana. I didn't always smoke pot. For years and years, Arj Barker was high on life. But eventually, I built up a tolerance. Some people think that I use marijuana to hide from my problems, but whatever. That would take a pretty big clump of marijuana for me to actually be able to hide behind it. I don't got that kind of money. And besides, the world's pretty fucked up right now. Shouldn't I be?
I mistakenly left a baggie of pot in my jacket when I dropped it off at the dry cleaners. It was the Marvin Gaye weed. You know, that's weed that's so strong, after one hit, you're like, what's going on? So I decided to go in there and get it. I marched into that dry cleaners and I handed the guy behind the counter my receipt. And he pressed that button that makes the big clothes carousel go around. And I could see riding through the store my jacket with the pot pinned to the lapel. It was like it was going to a pot prom or something. He smiled, I thought I was good to go. Then he says, that'll be $200, please. Yeah, he took a check, and I went home and got baked.
My girlfriend thinks I smoke too much pot. I, on the other hand, think I don't smoke enough pot. Because if I did, I'd be finished, and I'm not. Look, we all have our vices. I like to smoke a little weed. She likes to feed the baby. Hey. Yeah. Different strokes for different folks, right? Apples and oranges. Hey, isn't that your baby crying? Get off my back. Sorry, our baby.
The majority of anti-marijuana funding comes from the alcohol companies. That's right, alcohol companies. Because they're afraid that if people smoke dope, they won't want to drink. After all, how many times have you witnessed the following scenario?
Hey, Doug, you want a beer?
No thanks, Tony. I just got high.
Yeah, that pretty much happens all the time at my house. Or this classic.
Hey, Tony, you want to get baked?
Are you insane? I just finished a fucking sea breeze.
That's right. It's the same joke twice. In an effort to battle these anti-marijuana concerns, we of the Marijuana Logs pledge that over 80% of the proceeds from this show will go towards marijuana.
So how do we think pot feels? We they think pot is angry. Marijuana is illegal, and it's pissed off about it. Pot doesn't want to be illegal. What? What does pot want? Just to carry out its sacred and divine mission, to get you high. It doesn't want to be a problem in your life. Pot wants to bring you joy. Pot doesn't want to be snipped by dogs, confiscated, kept in an evidence locker, or worse, smoked by cops. Pot wants love. Pot wants acceptance. Embrace marijuana. Give it a hug. And then smoke the living out of it. America, what's the message of our performance tonight? It's quite simple, really. Kids don't do drugs.
I'm Annie Potts. We have PK, and we have our own Dank Bagman.
Yeah.
We're having a little technical troubles with our computer graphics.
Yeah, that's right. Earlier I said to watch the graphics, and you could call in, and I didn't realize the graphics weren't working. So it was a test to see if you were paying attention out there. And if you saw any graphics, you got a problem. Anyway.
You're smoking too much.
That's right.
Why don't you share?
Yeah, right. There you go. But anyway, the phone number is for the Amarillo Pot Hemp Fest, or to get in touch with us about the show, or is 541-344-2377. So I'll give it again at the end of the show also, but that's 541-344-2377. And you can call that number, and also you can write us email at Emerald Empire Hemp Fest, all one word, at hotmail.com.
All right. I think you had another article that was pretty important there, too.
Yeah, this is Grover Beach. Grover Beach has extended its moratorium on medical marijuana dispensaries and taken steps to make the ban permanent. By gosh. So it's funny, you know, one city legalizes, they set up dispensaries, and another one says, no, we don't want it here.
Yeah.
But anyway, it says the council voted 5-0 to extend the 180-day moratorium that would have expired April 19th. Without the extension, we'd have a period before a permanent ban was in place that would have allowed such dispensaries to be established within the city. The mayor, the city council voted 4-1 to make the ban permanent. The mayor dissented. He said while he's strongly opposed to recreational using marijuana or any drugs, he thinks the dispensary could be extremely problematic. He didn't want to give the message that the city was forever closing the door on using medical marijuana medicinally. But here's the upshot. My mother died of cancer, he said, while holding back tears. I do believe that in her case, and a lot of cases like hers, that marijuana could serve a purpose. If not curative, at least it would have eased her suffering.
Oh, you bet. You bet.
Quality of life.
And yet he still voted
to ban. It's all about quality of life.
But yet he still voted to ban the dispensary.
Oh, that makes
sense. He just voted against making it permanent.
Oh, man. That's bad. That's bad. Yeah.
Well, the Mercy Center is open on Wednesdays. We would like to hear from you. We need your help, volunteers. I know you people in Salem on Channel 23, you watch us. They get to talk to you on occasion. We need you in a lot of different ways. And let's see, on the 15th of this month, we're having a glassware party and a poster party to make up posters for the Million
Marijuana March. All right.
That's on the 6th of May. You know, big cities, little cities all around the world are going to be
protesting and marching, peacefully, of course.
Liberation.
Yep, liberation. To end prohibition, hopefully, but
that's
we got to keep fighting the good fight.
What's going on in Portland, Salem, and Seattle?
All around the world, actually.
Exactly, 118 cities,
I had the poster last year, and I was reading, it was like you know, Paris,
yeah.
And
oh, yeah.
I mean, all over the world.
Yeah.
So we're not, the United States isn't the only people crying out to say, hey, listen, you know,
no.
It's okay.
A lot of those European countries are, marijuana is legal because they know it's a medicine.
Oh, you bet, because they're doing the tests. You know, this country won't do the test because once they find that it is good for medicinal, then the government has to cop to it.
Mm-hmm.
Over there, they're doing the test because their government is copping to it. They're saying, yes, we found that it has medicinal purposes. Unfortunately, though, Cincinnati increased penalty for marijuana possession.
Yeah, it's been that. Cincinnati,
yeah.
Ohio. Unbelievable.
Yeah, unbelievable. We get one good one and then we get a bad one. If you smoke marijuana in Cincinnati, you could end up in jail. The council has voted to increase the penalty for possession of up to 100 grams, about 3.5 ounces of the drug. It makes a crime, a fourth degree misdemeanor punishable by up to 30 days in jail and a fine up to $250. Boy, that's bad. It has been a minor misdemeanor, which carries a maximum penalty of $100 fine. That's what it was. While the minor misdemeanor gets a offender a ticket, a fourth degree misdemeanor warrants immediate arrest. The council's vote also makes a second offense a first degree misdemeanor punishable by up to 6 months in jail and $1,000 fine. Is that crazy or what? The ordinance is in effect immediately.
Yeah.
Expires in 12 months if the council does not vote to continue it.
See, that's in Ohio.
That's
not really known as being a real liberal state or really with it, you know.
No, obviously not.
Ohio.
Yeah. I think I'm going to stay away from Cincinnati,
yeah.
I'll tell you what.
When I used to drive truck, that was one of the states that we didn't like.
That you stayed away from?
Stay away from, yeah. Yeah, that was one of them. You'd call them the communist states.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah, might as well be. Police
yeah.
state.
Yeah.
They're going to put you in jail for, that's just unbelievable.
Yeah. Oh, it's
unbelievable.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, speaking of studies, London, United Kingdom, they did an administration of Centivix, the oral spray,
mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
on a whole bunch of MS patients, and they found that it was very, very good for them, which we all know.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, obviously, mm-hmm. and that's a really debilitating disease, too.
Oh, Sabinex, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Well, Thomas was talking about how that was supposed to come into play here in the United States. So hopefully we'll hear more about that. Hopefully he'll be back. But anyway, I think we've come to the end of our program. And
well,
don't believe the propaganda.
It's been real. It's been fun. It's been real fun.
No, we've got a lot of difficulties tonight.
That's right. Remember,
but we're here anyway.
541-344-2377. You over there, get your pen. That's 541-344-2377. Give us a call. If you'd like to donate, like to help, even if you don't like the program, we got you.
We like all comments.
That's right. And Salem, go up to Salem and find people at the merchant center.
363-4-5.